photographs on there that you can look at. So a lot of the places I take photographs are usually like businesses or outside. So this is me gaining experience and experimenting with like studio lights. So thank you for being a part. You like that? Okay. Let's take a couple more. Okay. But you're doing great. I love the the poses with the hands. Okay, so pull your shirt down just so you can see the letter. Gotcha. Great. So tell me a little.
Yeah. So do you ever do a lot of portrait stuff?
So actually, a lot of the work there is primarily like where I usually take photographs, which is the streets. So portrait photography, like staging up a scene and using studio lights, is something that I just started doing. So I'm trying to gain the experience, and it's great to work with the community to create
the
experience.
Too,
and you get a copy.
That's good.
And so that's one of my favorite parts about it. See if I can block this sun.
Did you?
Hey, what's up? I didn't send you the paper. So, thank y'all for coming out. For sure. I love when it's small, intimate people that I know, so we can talk and vibe about some shit. And so, if you haven't already, look at the work, look at the books, pick up a postcard or two. I have pens. So, what does it mean to be black? So, first of all, I intentionally told white people not to come. So, today is a black space. You be as black as you want to be, as proud as you want to be, without having to think about that white devil on the shoulder. anybody got a, you know, a white family or whatever. It is what it is. And so the zine is a very simple, basic zine of portraits of people. On one side, there's a portrait. On the other side, it's their response to what does it mean to be black. And it's a beautiful zine. As you may, most of you may know, a lot of my work is built on the back of community. So it's about listening and trying to provide this conversation that shows our connectedness and our togetherness. And so the zine did really well. I won an award for it. It was like it's third best book in Baltimore for that year.
Okay.
I didn't make a lot of money off of it, which wasn't the goal. The goal was to spread it out as much as I could.
For sure.
And it was also one of my like first major projects, so I made a lot of mistakes, but it worked out really well. And so the postcards were just a part of the programming that I was having in Baltimore for this event. And so I would invite all of these people, social media, and you can have more than one. You're probably going to need more than one for what we're going to do. And so the programming, I invited some people and I did a small, very brief conversation on what it meant to be black.
No, it's not, bro.
Okay, y'all got it?
Yeah.
We're good.
Five images, ASAP.
Copies and examples of the studio advertisements. And so, what I'm gonna do is distribute these flyers through the west side of Charlotte so I can take family portraits and just portraits of people. And so if you all want one, you can have one. And these are my flyers. So I tried to kind of like stick with the same type of language, the same type of feel, while trying to also pay homage and kind of embody with these old flyers and old advertisements were, because they serve such a large purpose during that time. Think about 1940s and the 50s. Portraiture, we've had portraiture before we had candid shots and selfies and shit. So portraiture has always been a large important factor and part of history. And so I just kind of want to preserve that. Also gain experience, because there's nothing like looking at a portrait and having only that person's body language and facial expression and aesthetic to rely on. And how portraiture was a part of, like, you think about people taking photos. You think about, like, there's this photographer I whose work I love. His name is James Vanderzee. And he took a lot of photographs of black New Yorkers, particularly like in the 30s. You think about the 30s, that's Jim Crow. And you can see just the progression, and not even the progression, but the change in black people from that time moving forward. And so we take portraits differently, our body language is differently. You know, thinking about black people having that portraits taken in the 20s, people were not smiling. Now we smile in photographs, we hug each other, we show love to one another. But in so many decades, we look so different, our body language, the portraits are just so different. Thinking about someone like Sojourner Truth, who had her photographs taken and claimed agency over her own self, like that's something that we're doing, but we don't even know that we're doing in the same type of revolutionary way. And so take some portraits, take some flyers, we'll give everybody one, and share with some people. If you want to have your portrait taken in your home or your backyard or a family photograph or something, and it's totally free, and because you all are like customers now, it's totally free, you get quality prints. So yeah, I wanted to share that with y'all. I'm pretty proud of these flyers. in order for me, and thinking about also, again, people who have accessibility to smartphones and the internet and stuff, so much of what I do does not rely on social media. And this is a way to kind of attest to that, and a way to meet people where they are and not require them to have the fanciest, latest stuff, but really just require you to have a couple, some eyes and can read, or at least share this amongst yourselves and your family. And so, certainly wanted to give y'all some flyers so y'all can take home.
When are you starting? When are you starting these appointments?
I'm gonna start passing these out. My students don't know that they're gonna help me, but they're gonna help me come Monday. And so I teach at the Lorien, which is on Arty near Wilkinson. Okay, look at me. Yeah, trying to figure it out. Yeah, it's right around the corner. So we usually do photo walks around the neighborhood, maybe for like an hour. So they're gonna help me. They just don't know yet.
Shan made me feel pretty. I walked into this with no makeup on, hair not done. She wraps the fabric around me and told me how to pose. And when I saw the finished result, I was like, oh, I'm cute. So I appreciate her inspiration and her focus and knowing what she wanted this project to look like and allowing me to be in it and coaching me through the process.
She was really, really nice. She was able to explain her project and the concept of it very well and thorough enough that I kind of understood what she was trying to do. So she's a great photographer.
Well, as a black woman, I believe that, you know, it's great to have representation, and I think that this allows us to have representation, allows us to see ourselves in different, and how we all look. Like, we're not all the same, and without makeup, with makeup, young, old, you know. So I really think that as a black woman, I believe in this project, and I think it's just dope, you know.
The archive is hugely important. The number one thing that people try to do to oppress a people is dismantle their history, or, you know, split up their history, split up their literature, split up their art. And so having something tangible, something that will stand the test of time, that future generations can look back on and see the power and the movements that are going on right now, is something that will, you know, fortify them in the future and help them to get over whatever oppressions are being placed upon them then.
Yeah.
get one more.
It's so easy to photograph black people in poverty. It's so easy to tokenize us because we are the culture. We are the thing. We are the topic of conversation. But so much of me, I have so much integrity, and I believe in being responsible. And being in Baltimore, it's like Baltimore's a bright black city. The people that I photograph are people on the street. So it's junkies, it's alcoholics, it's working people, it's kids, it's high school dropouts, it's bus drivers, I mean whoever. And that's a very broad umbrella of black people. And I try to be really responsible. So the goal is to not tokenize you or take a photo of you that you might be ashamed of, that you might not take pride in. It's to show you who you are and to show you who I am and to connect us. And so back to being a black artist, I just feel like that, again, a lot of us look at art through the white gaze because the standards of art, we barely see ourselves in museums in the first place, especially ones that have been historically white. And what we do, there's always a catch. You get what I'm saying? Like, it's like, okay, this art isn't here, but why? You know, like, not, and it's not about the artist who made it, but why does this institution have it in the first place? And then you gotta also realize that the people around you looking at the art don't look like you. And so for me, it's like, yeah, I'm a black artist, I'm a proud black person, a proud black woman, and I proudly center black people and blackness in my work, and I don't plan on assimilating, I don't plan on changing it up. I mean, I do freelance work and stuff, so I take pictures of all sorts of people, but my artistic work, the work that I care the most about, is about black people. I actually prefer to teach only black students, and not to discriminate, not because I don't think that I can, but because I think that we require a certain special attention. We require so much, and we should have to share. You get what I'm saying? And so, black everything for me. And so, yeah, Toni Morrison talked about, she embraced being a black artist, and I've talked to other artists about it, and some of them are like, I don't want to be called a black artist because it labels me, because it puts me in a box, and I don't feel like it's a box at all. But you also gotta realize, you also gotta think about how you want your box to look. You know, like, do you want to define your box for yourself, or you want somebody else to find it for you? I mean, artistically, the art world, which is, you know, we know, is going to put you in a box, and they're going to decorate that box for you, they're going to make it real nice, they're going to put the label and everything on there, and you might take it and accept it. I'm not doing none of that shit. I'm going to make my box, I'm going to step outside of my box, I'm going to upgrade my box, my box going to wear Pradas and everything like that. Like, you know, and so that's my way of creating my own box and also taking a stance and never, ever, ever leaving my people behind. My blackness is on the forefront. My blackness is the biggest part of me. And I take my people wherever I go. And we are all black. And so it's just a way to just truly put us at the forefront. Because when you hear black, you just think of it. You think of black. When people who are not black think of black, they think of us. So it's like, at all times, I certainly want you to think about my people, I want you to think about my community when you are introducing me, or when you're looking at my work, or you're reading my bio, doesn't matter. And one thing I also realize is that a lot of, and not judging anybody, to each his own, you know, this is all a process, we all learn, things all change, some of us go by certain different titles and labels, whatever, but I'm someone who doesn't have an issue publicly saying that my work is for black people. And I realized that is a problem for some people. And we all got our own shit to work through. You know, we all got our own conflicts and everything like that. But I take pride in being brave to say, hey, my work is for black people. My work is for us. And I have no shame in that. And that could seem limiting to some people. It could seem limiting to some institutions. But if that's the case, I don't give a fuck, because the work is for us. It's not to be mainstream. I don't want to be a commercial artist. I like doing local stuff. I like impacting communities, regardless if they're small or they're large. And so that's my take on that. I feel really passionate about being called a black artist. And to each his own, again, some people don't like it, some people do, but I certainly share that same sentiment with Toni Morrison and many other artists who only reference black work, who only makes black work, who only create black figures. You know, and again, to me, it might seem limited to some people, but we own all of this shit. All of this shit is ours. You know, all of this shit is about us. And so why not just center it at all times?